Because it's being created within an activity, it can be terminated as simply as rotating the phone into a different orientation. So it should only ever be used for tasks whose life cycle is tied to the host activity, and is expected to run for only a second or two. On mobile, it's unwise to assume that even the most trivial network access is going to happen quickly. So a better approach would be to use a service. An application component without a UI that's less likely to be interrupted, possibly scheduled using an inexact repeating alarm. Even better, Android has a specialized solution known as a sync adapter, and it's designed especially to schedule your background data syncs as efficiently as possible. Better still would be using Google Cloud Messaging. This lets you notify your sync adapter of changes on the server side, so you're only ever initiating network requests from your app when you know there's something to be updated on the server. For now, we're concentrating on making our app work when it's in the foreground, but we'll return to look at these approaches to invisibly updating your app from the background a little later. For now, keep in mind that the refresh button and the new thread solution is just a placeholder while we hook up the rest of the app.